Hi everyone, welcome back to the current affairs series of agriculture and rural development. My name is Pooja Rawat and this is our 21st session. So in the previous session we were discussing about the provisions of Union Budget 2021-22 which are specifically related to your agriculture or the rural sector. Alright, so we'll continue with that in this session also. So before we begin our session, all those people who are here for the first time, do subscribe our channel and press this bell icon so that you don't miss on the latest updates. You can also join our Telegram group wherein you can post your queries, you can discuss among peers, and you'll also be updated with the latest videos. Let's begin our session. This is the first question. It says, Union Budget 2021-22 has extended the coverage of Operation Green Scheme to how many perishable commodities? So Operation Green Scheme jo hai, it was launched in 2018 by Ministry of Food Processing Industries. The objective was to stabilize the processes of three commodities. So there were three commodities initially, which was TOP, your tomatoes, onions and potatoes. Alright. So this scheme now has been extended to how many commodities? 22 commodities. Okay, so option C here is correct. So this scheme is a kind of a price stabilization scheme. Alright. So jab bhi market mein kya supply zyada hoti hai, whenever there is a surplus production of these commodities or market mein supply zyada ho jati hai, there are chances of crashing of the prices, hai na? So is scenario mein, us condition mein farmer ko kya hoga, ek adequate amount uske produce ke liye nahi mil payega kyunki prices would fall. So in that scenario government will intervene or NAFED agency is the implementing agency here. So NAFED will procure the surplus amount and will eliminate the mismatch between the demand and supply of these products, right, of these commodities. Or agar supply kam hoti hai kisi, if in any year there is a fall in the production level, so government kya karegi, jo bhi storaged product hoga, commodity hongi jo already se procure ki hui hai government ne, usko market mein launch karegi. So the demand and supply mismatch could be eliminated. Alright, so this is how this scheme works, and there are other objectives involved as well, so we'll discuss them in detail. Okay, so this was launched in 2018 by Ministry of Food Processing Industries. Objectives were first to contain the wide price volatility. Okay, so as I've already mentioned ki agar supply zyada ho jati hai, toh there are chances of the price crashing. So in that scenario, NAFED will intervene and NAFED will procure the surplus amount, alright, and the mismatch between the demand and supply would be eliminated. Now, remember one thing, that the government has the twin objective of providing remunerative prices to the farmers. Okay, farmers ko kya karna hai, ek remunerative provide karna hai. Second objective government ka hamesha rehta hai, affordability ko maintain karna. Alright, affordability ko maintain karna, for whom? For the consumers, for end consumers who are consuming these products, these commodities. Alright, the government ko hamesha ek balance bana ke rakhna padta hai prices ke beech mein, so that it should be remunerative enough for the farmers and it should be affordable enough for the end consumer. Second objective of this scheme was building efficient value chains. Now efficient value chain se kya matlab hai yahan pe? So aapka kya hota hai, jab bhi aap koi commodity ka production kar rahe hain field level pe, so there are different services or activities involved, from its transportation from the field level till it's reach the end consumer. Theek hai, to jab tak field se end consumer ke beech काफ़ी सारी एक्टिविटीज़ एंड सर्विसेज इन्वॉल्व होती हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल ग्रेडिंग, फॉर एग्जांपल पैकेजिंग, प्रोसेसिंग, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, सर्टिफिकेशन, ऑल दीज सर्विसेज आर इन्वॉल्व. तो इस पूरी की पूरी चेन को, और हर एक स्टेज जो होती है वो कुछ ना कुछ वैल्यू ऐड कर रही होती है, राइट. सो इस पूरी की पूरी चेन को एफिशिएंट बनाने के लिए this scheme is going to get will give the help to the necessary or the involved stakeholders. Now third objective was to reduce the post harvest losses. तो ये सारी भी जितनी भी कमोडिटीज़ हैं वो पेरिशेबल हैं नेचर, राइट? तो शेल्फ लाइफ इसकी बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं है. तो अगर आप प्रॉपर स्टोरेज फैसिलिटीज़ या वेयर हाउसेज प्रोवाइड नहीं करेंगे तो दीज कमोडिटीज़ विल बी पेरिश्ड एंड द फार्मर्स विल नॉट बी एबल टू गेट द रेम्यूनरेटिव प्राइस और द एडिक्वेट अमाउंट फॉर देयर प्रोड्यूस. ऑलराइट, सो थर्ड ऑब्जेक्टिव इज़ टू रिड्यूस द पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट लॉसेज. नाउ हाउ द गवर्नमेंट इज़ गोइंग टू डू दैट? फर्स्ट बाय स्ट्रेंथनिंग द प्रोडक्शन क्लस्टर्स एंड एफपीओस. ठीक है, जो भी फार्मर प्रोड्यूसर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैं या प्रोडक्शन क्लस्टर्स हैं उनको फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस देके उनको स्ट्रेंथन आउट करेंगे. कोशिश किया जाएगा कि सारे के सारे फार्मर्स को क्लस्टर्स के फॉर्म में ऑर्गेनाइज किया जाए. देन बाय कनेक्टिंग देम टू द टर्मिनल मार्केट्स. ओके, सो बाय कनेक्टिंग दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू द मार्केट कनेक्टिविटी प्रोवाइड की जाएगी. बाय इन्वेस्टिंग इन द पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर टू रिड्यूस द लॉसेस. ओके, तो पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में आपके वेयर हाउसेज हैं, आपके कोल्ड स्टोरेज फैसिलिटीज़ हैं, तो यहाँ इन्वेस्टमेंट किया जाएगा. एंड द लास्ट, बाय इंक्रीजिंग द फूड प्रोसेसिंग कैपेबिलिटीज बाय गिविंग फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस टू द फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्रीज सो दैट द वैल्यू कैन बी एडेड टू दिस प्रोड्यूस और टू दीज कमोडिटीज. नाउ इनिशियली इट वॉज फॉर दीज थ्री कमोडिटीज, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट. नाउ इट्स बीन एक्सटेंडेड टू 22 पेरिशेबल कमोडिटीज. So it will support the diversification at the farm level, right? So the farmers honge, they will not be afraid of growing these commodities at their farm level since they already know that the government is going to give support or to give assistance for these commodities, right? So they will going to get good price for these produce or for these commodities. Now moving forward to the next question, it says budget 2021-22 has proposed a new levy, agriculture infrastructure development cess. Okay, so this cess has been recently been proposed by the government in this budget. You need to identify on how many products this cess would be levied. So the correct answer here is A, that is the 29 products. Okay, let's talk about that in detail. So this cess recently been launched in this year and it is expected to generate an amount of rupees 30,000 crore. Okay, so this cess jo hai iska targeted amount jo government ne rakha hai ki ye at least 30,000 crore rupees generate karega. Cess ka purpose ye hota hai to create a dedicated pool of fund, hai na, ek dedicated pool of fund banaya jaye jis bhi cheez ke liye isko levy kiya ja raha hai. Agar clean energy cess hai to ek uske उस सेस के अंतर्गत जितना भी फंड जनरेट होगा वुड बी यूटिलाइज फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग क्लीन एनर्जी, है ना. इसीलिए एग्रीकल्चर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट सेस है तो जितना भी फंड जनरेट होगा दैट वुड बी यूटिलाइज इन क्रिएटिंग द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर रिलेटेड टू एग्रीकल्चर ओनली. दिस फंड कैन नॉट बी यूटिलाइज एनीवेयर एल्स. सेकेंड, इसका बेनिफिट ये होता है सेस का कि यह डिविजिबल पूल में नहीं होता है. डिविजिबल पूल में नहीं होता है, इसका मतलब क्या है कि जो भी इसमें फंड जनरेट हो रहे द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट नीड नॉट टू डिवाइड इट बिटवीन द स्टेट्स. ओके, सो स्टेट और सेंटर के बीच में डिवाइड नहीं किया जाएगा. सेंटर कैन यूटिलाइज दिस एंटायर फंड फॉर द सेट ऑब्जेक्टिव. ओके, तो इसीलिए सेस लगाया जाता है. द सेस विल बी लेवीड ऑन 29 प्रोडक्ट्स एंड द प्रोमिनेंट अमंग देम आर द गोल्ड, सिल्वर, द इम्पोर्टेड एप्पल, इम्पोर्टेड एल्कोहल, imported pulses, imported palm oil and the imported यूरियम. तो ये जितने भी प्रोडक्ट्स इम्पोर्ट किए जा रहे हैं इनमें ये लेवी लगाया जाएगा, टैक्स लगाया जाएगा. एडिशनली द सेस वुड ऑल्सो भी लेवीड ऑन द पेट्रोल एंड डीजल. तो पेट्रोल पर कितना रुपीज़ 2.5 पर लीटर का सेस लगाया जाएगा और डीजल में रुपीज़ 4.5 रुपीज़ 4 पर लीटर का सेस लगाया जाएगा. सो वन थिंग दैट इज़ नीड टू बी रिमेंबर्ड कि एक एडिशनल सेस नहीं है, कंज्यूमर के ऊपर एडिशनल टैक्स नहीं लगाया जा रहा है. दे this cess would basically offset the excise duty. तो जो existing excise duty या custom duty है उसी को offset करके ये cess लगाए जा रहे हैं. ठीक है, yeah, so this was all about the agriculture infrastructure and development cess. Remember this. Third question here is rural infrastructure development fund can be deployed in where? So this was the fund which was generated or created in 1985-86, I guess. sorry 1995-96. So in this year, and the NABARD is the implementing agency. Remember this point, right? So you need to identify where we can use this fund. First is the agriculture infrastructure, correct? Second is the public health institution, and the third is sanitation. So all these statements are correct. क्यों? क्योंकि RIDF आपका एग्री इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में यूज़ हो सकता है, देन आपके सोशल सोशल सेक्टर में यूज़ हो सकते हैं, ठीक है? सोशल सेक्टर में अगर यूज़ होता है तो इसके अंदर आपका पब्लिक हेल्थ इंस्टीट्यूशंस आ जाएंगे, है ना? आपका सैनिटेशन भी आ जाएगा, देन सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट. सो इन सभी एक्टिविटीज़ में इस फंड को यूटिलाइज किया जा सकता है. Alright, and then there is another category, agri sector hai, social sector hai. And the another category we have with us is rural connectivity. Okay, rural connectivity. So all these options are correct. The correct answer would be D here. So RIDF was set up by the government in the year 1995-96 for financing ongoing rural infrastructure project. Okay, so already जो project run हो रहे हैं, infrastructure project run हो रहे हैं, अगर in any time they face fund crunch in implementing these projects, so they can get financial assistance through this fund. So this fund is maintained by NABARD. ओके, तो NABARD क्या करेगी, इस फंड को मेंटेन करेगी और लोन प्रोवाइड करती है स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को और बाकी स्टेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को. यस, सो ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू प्रोवाइड लोन्स टू द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड स्टेट ओन्ड कॉरपोरेशन टू कंप्लीट दिस ऑनगोइंग रूरल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट्स. ऑलराइट, सो ये चीज़ याद रखिए कि नए प्रोजेक्ट्स को फाइनेंस नहीं करें, जो ऑलरेडी ऑनगोइंग प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं वही, अगर उन्हीं प्रोजेक्ट्स में कभी फंड क्रंच आ जाता है तो दे विल गेट फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस थ्रू दिस फंड. So the activities that would be financed under this fund would fall under three categories. First is your agriculture related sector, second is your social sector, and the third is rural connectivity. Okay, so जो भी rural roads हैं उनको अगर construct करने में कोई fund चाहिए, so they can utilize this. Now there has been a 33% increase in the budgeted amount under this fund, and it has reached 10,000 crore. Okay, that's why I have included this question here. Because the fund, although it was established in 1995, but recently there was an increase in the allocated amount under this fund. Now the fourth question we have is PM Atmanirbhar Swasth Bharat Yojana was announced in budget 2021. So this scheme was announced in this year. You need to identify the correct statement with respect to it. First is, it aims to improve health infrastructure at all levels in tier 2 and tier 3 cities as well as the rural areas. So this one is absolutely correct. So it's going to improve or strengthen the health infrastructure at all the levels, whether it is primary or secondary or the tertiary level. So in sabhi levels pe health infrastructure jo hai usko strengthen out kiya jayega in tier 2 tier 3 cities or the rural areas. Second is, it will strengthen the disease surveillance. This is also correct. So this is another component under this scheme where the government is striving to strengthen the disease surveillance through establishment of a portal, ek dedicated portal hoga jo ki in diseases ko track karega, wherein the data will be fed by the primary health care providers or the grassroots level health providers or the laboratories that we have. So all these organization, all these workers will feed in the data, the real time data on this platform, and so a data set would be generated and this will track the progress of that disease. All right, so third statement here is, all public health laboratories will be connected through the expanded integrated health information portal. Okay, so this portal was launched and all the health laboratories would be connected with this portal. They will feed in the data regarding the diseases, regarding the mentioned diseases in this scheme, and a database would be generated, right? So all these statements are correct, and the correct option here would be D, that is all of the above. Now this is the last question, and says, government has proposed to connect another 1,000 mandis to the ENAM, which and you need to identify which is the lead agency for the implementation of this ENAM project. So ENAM is nothing but your online trading portal. This is an pan India online trading portal where the farmers can sell their produce. All right, so already there were 1000 mandis that have been connected. Now the government has proposed to connect another 1000 mandis with this platform. So which is the agency that is implementing this ENAM? Okay, the option here are SFAC, NABARD, NAFED or the RBI. The correct answer here is Small Farmer Agri Business Consortium. This is the agency that is implementing ENAM and it falls under Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So remember this point. All right, so this was all about today's session. I hope you like it. In case you have any queries, you can post it down on the comment section. And yeah, we'll see you in the next session. Till then, keep working hard, keep studying. Goodbye.